Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of Homing TV. Today I will tell you all about Dorico's propagation feature, and also a tip to improve your workflow speed. Simply put, propagating in Dorico is a way to copy settings from a layout or properties, and then paste them to other layout or, again, properties items. For example, I have a violin layout that I want to change its appearance. And I also want these modifications to appear in my second violin layout. For that, I will open the layouts of the first violin by opening the drop-down menu and clicking on the first violin layout. Then I want to modify the layout's properties. So I will open the layout options for the violin, well, actually the first violin, and then click on layout options. And now I will turn this one to A3 and the orientation to landscape, and then click on apply and close. And now, as you can see, the layout has changed to what we specified. Now I want my second violin layout to be the same. But instead of, again, modifying the layout settings, I can easily just copy and paste the settings. In order to do that, right-click on any of the layouts, and then click on Propagate Part Formatting. Then select the source layout to copy the settings from, which is Violin 1, and then choose the layout that you want the settings to be pasted on. And also, you can select multiple layouts if you want. But I only want it to be pasted into Violin 2, so I'll just click on it. Now, here there are two options that you can select. The first one will tell Dorico that you want the layout options to be copied. And the second one tells Dorico that you also want to copy the system formatting. I'll also talk about that in a moment. Let's untick Include System Formatting for now, and then click on OK. And now, if I go to my second violin layout, you'll see that it also is the same as my first violin. And now, going back to talk about the second tick in the Propagate Part Formatting window, which tells Dorico to also copy the system and page breaks, I will head to the Engrave tab to find a section that I want to modify its system break. Then I will click on a note, and then head to the left panel, and then hit on Create System Break. And now I want the settings to be duplicated in my other layout as well. But first, I will put both of the layouts side by side so we can see them better. All right, so we have Violin 2 on the left and Violin 1 on the right. I'm just gonna zoom out a little bit here, and then I'll go back to the setup section in the layouts and right click. You can actually right click on any of these layouts, it doesn't make a difference. Then I'll go to Propagate Part Formatting, and since this time I modified the second violins, I want to copy the settings from them and paste them to the first violin. So I'll do copy formatting from and to. And what I'm going to do now is to turn this one on and turn this include layout options off. And just a tip, and that is either of these two options only work if there is a difference between the layouts. If there is no change, even if these options are ticked, nothing will happen. And to show you this, I'll also tick the option to include the layout options. And since there's no new change, none of the layouts of my scores will be modified. All right, now let's click on this one again. All right, and now I press OK. I'm gonna close these. Now you can see how my system breaks are also copied. Super neat when working on big projects or orchestral works. So this is one way of propagating in Dorico. But before I go to the next one, if you are still watching this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and also check out my other fun and educational videos on interesting topics about music. So the other propagate feature is quite different, and the concept of it is that it's about propagating settings between your full score and parts. And that's why I have a full score on the left and the part on my right side. And in a way, if you propagate a certain settings, it will mirror it in the other counterpart. So you can propagate from full score to parts or the other way around. Let's see it in action. Say I want to modify this triplet to look different. I'm just gonna go to engrave mode, open my properties below. Oop. All right. Better than number. There you see, it changes. But the interesting thing is that it doesn't change in your part, so it's still looking as it was before. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. And this is where the propagating properties come into play. Simply put, the procedure copies the settings from one or multiple selected items and then paste them on its counterpart on the other layout. And in order to use it, I will first select the item that is modified by clicking on it. So this one. And then I'll go to the edit, go down and propagate properties. And if we check the part again, the triplet on my violin part now looks the same as in my full score right here. And as I told you, this action works both ways, so you can also change things in your part and it will also be reflected in your full score. Now you might think, why does not this work automatically? Honestly, I really don't know, but I think it should be on this. This setting should be on from the beginning, that it just replicate whatever you're doing to its counterpart. But I will tell you in a moment how you can set up Dorico that it works automatically, and it would always mirror every settings from parts to the full score and vice versa. Important thing to know is that the propagate properties works only per action and click. So it is not going to latch on, and if you modify something, anything, you have to propagate it again. But if you want this feature to latch and always work, you can open the edit drop-down menu right here, then head to the preferences, note input and editing, and just scroll down until you find the properties section. Yes, right here. It says, when starting a new project, set local properties to locally or globally. Now I'm gonna click on globally. By global, it means that everything in your score and parts will always be mirrored, and by local, it means that it stays separate. So if I just click on OK, from now on, every properties modification will be mirrored either in the full score or the parts. I'm gonna click on OK now. The other way is to go to the write mode or engrave mode and open the properties section. And on the right side, you will notice that we have the same option here as well. And the nice thing here is that you can leave it on globally, or you can just switch it on to global properties, modify some settings, and then switch it back to local again. So you can alternate between having your properties linked or separate. And bear in mind that, as I told you, this turns on the linking between the layout properties of full score and layouts. Now this is the important part. This will only work for the changes that you make after you switch this to globally. So if there is anything before from turning the settings to global, you need to do them manually again with the method I just told you a bit before. All right, that's it everyone. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, please do leave them in the comment section below. And as usual, please don't forget to share, like, subscribe, and also turn the notification on so you can stay up to date with the channel. And till next time, Homayun out.